Hello everyone, I am Venkatesh. I would like to present multi-channel unit for music source separation. The goal of music source separation task is to estimate the audio sources present in the input music audio. For example, consider the following music clip, which comprises of the sources, vocals, drums, bass, and others. A source separation system should be able to estimate the sources present in this music clip, namely vocals, drums, bass, and others. In this work, we investigate the performance of different types of music source separation systems. To train our music source separation system, we choose MuseDB 18 as our dataset. MuseDB 18 consists of 150 full-length stereo audio tracks. The ground truth sources are made available in two settings. In two source setting, vocals and accompaniment sources are provided, whereas in four source setting, we have vocals, drums, bass, and the rest. The dataset also comes with a predefined split of 100 full-length tracks for the training set and 50 full-length tracks for the test set. Music source separation systems can be categorized into one of the three variants shown in this figure. Type A system is comprised of K single input, single output models trained independently of each other. Each model only estimates a particular source. A type B model, on the other hand, consists of a single input, single output model that estimates a particular source based on the applied conditioning. The control unit responsible for conditioning the model introduces additional trainable parameters along with the model parameters. Note that each input sample needs to be passed k times through the model, each time with the conditioning specific to a particular source. A type C system contains a single input multi-output model. Unlike in type B systems, no additional control parameters are required in type C systems. As we move from type A system to type C system, the number of trainable network parameters reduces. In this work, we explore and compare the performance of these types of music source separation systems. For type A, we consider a dedicated unit system. In this system, each model corresponds to a unit and there are as many units as the number of sources to be estimated. UNET follows an encoder-decoder architecture with skip connections in between. We choose UNET for their simplicity and ease of training. Hence, we only consider UNET-based systems throughout the work. The UNET predicts soft mask, which on multiplication with the input mixture spectrogram yields the magnitude spectrogram of the estimated source. We combine the obtained magnitude spectrogram with the phase of the input mixture spectrogram and then apply inverse short time Fourier transform to get the audio waveform. For type B, we consider conditioned unit. The conditioned unit contains unit as the basic building block. The control unit generates the control parameters to adapt the unit to estimate a particular source corresponding to the applied conditioning. For type C, we consider a multi-channel unit. A multi-output model needs to be trained with the multitask loss function. In this loss function, we consider the following loss term definitions: direct loss and indirect loss. The direct loss is defined on the masks, while indirect loss is defined on the spectrograms. To determine the weights in the multitask loss function, we investigate the following weighting schemes. In naive unit weighting, we assign unit weights to all the loss terms. In dynamic weighted average method, the weights are distributed such that a loss term decreasing at a higher rate is assigned a lower weight than the loss term that does not decrease much. We noticed that the energy distribution across the sources are not uniform. In two source setting, the accompaniment has higher average energy than the vocals. In four source setting, the difference in energy levels across sources is not as pronounced as in two source setting, but bass has slightly higher average energy than all the other sources. On the basis of differences in energy distribution across the sources, we explore the following energy-based weighting schemes listed below. EBW-P1, EBW-Instantaneous P1, EBW-P2, and another weighting strategy from O et al. In this table, we list the number of trainable network parameters, number of training iterations per epoch, and processing rate at inference for all the three source operation systems. We notice that the multi-channel unit has the least number of trainable parameters and it requires the least number of training iterations per epoch than compared to the dedicated units and conditioned unit. It also has considerably higher sample processing rate at the inference than the conditioned unit. In this table, we list the results of singing voice separation experiments. Higher the SDR, the better. Note that the multi-channel unit with energy-based weighting strategies performed better than the dedicated units and conditioned unit despite having the least training cost. A more elaborate tabulation of results can be found on the project page. Here is an example from the two source setting. The ground truth vocals of a sample sounds like this. The conditioned unit vocals estimate sounds like this. The multi-channel unit vocals estimate sounds like this. Note that several harmonics are missing in the conditioned unit's estimate, unlike that of multi-channel unit. Also, the conditioned unit's vocal estimate contains many artifacts. More examples are available on the project page. In this table, we list the results of multi-instrument source separation experiments. Again, higher the SDR, the better. In the case of drums, rest, and overall, multi-channel unit with energy-based weighting strategies performed better than the dedicated units and conditioned unit, despite having the least training cost. A more elaborate tabulation of the results can be found on the project page. Here is an example from the four source setting. The ground truth bass of a sample sounds like this. The conditioned unit bass estimate sounds like this. The multi-channel unit bass estimate sounds like this. Note that there are certain artifacts in the conditioned unit's bass estimate, unlike that of multi-channel unit. More examples on the project page. Finally, we conduct ablation studies to evaluate which loss definition among direct loss and indirect loss performs better. We also analyze the effect of including silent source samples during training. Based on the overall performance metrics, we recommend using indirect loss definition and discarding silent source samples during training. Multi-channel unit is a computationally cheaper alternative to conditioned unit and the system of dedicated units for music source separation. It is also considerably faster than the conditioned unit at inference. When the sources to be separated have different energy values on average, energy-based weighting strategy seems to be helpful in determining the weights of the multitask loss function during training. Discarding silent source samples during training saves on the training cost without much compromise in performance. Multi-channel unit performs better when trained with an indirect loss term rather than the direct loss term on the masks. The source code and more examples are available on our project webpage. Thank you.